In this video, we are going to arrange our pieces on our avatar. So by now, you should make sure you have the right fabric that you want to use and obviously your pattern all drafted and ready to go. I'm going to go ahead and close out my library so I have more space. I actually don't even think I need my object browser or property editor windows open either, so it gives me a little bit more space. And you know what I might even do is select all my pattern pieces. I'm in the tool where the keyboard shortcuts the letter A. Might click and drag and select them all. And maybe I'll just like move them over my 3D window just for right now. Okay, so to put your pattern pieces on your avatar, you should use the arrange tool. You can hit Command F if you're on a Mac or Control F if you are on a PC. If you cannot remember keyboard shortcuts, Shift F. See, I already cannot remember keyboard shortcuts. There's also the toggle menu here. So go ahead and click that. Then you just have all these blue dots. So click one pattern piece, in this case at a time. You can click multiple pieces if you had like a whole bunch, like they're kind of grouped together. But in this case, I'm just gonna do one at a time. So I'm gonna click the front bodice and I'm just gonna go ahead and look for a point. So I'm clicking this little blue point that's right under her bust, kind of on her side. And I think this is great. I think that's the one I'm gonna click on. But just a demo to you, see what happens if I click on her, the blue one on her thigh, it brings it down here. So it kind of like centers the piece. So I don't wanna pick her middle because then it's gonna center, let me see if I zoom in a little bit. It's gonna center the whole thing. I definitely don't want it placed centered like that. In this case, I do want it on the side. So all I have to do is just click that little blue dot. So click, great. I can zoom out. I'm gonna click the back piece. And you can select the piece in the 2D window or you can select it in the 3D, it's fine. You can right click to rotate. I love though hitting the keyboard shortcuts, the numbers to just kind of quickly jump views. I hit the number 8 in that case. If you forget, you can just hit the numbers till like you get there. Okay, so then again, I'm gonna find the blue dot. I think maybe this one's a little too low. I'll do this one up a little higher. This looks great. I'm just gonna click that one time and it sets it there. Now I'll grab the sleeve. Now you wanna notice where your notch is. So if you have one notch, that's usually your front. The double notch is the back. So pay attention if your pattern has those notches. I'm gonna grab her arm, just click it right there. I think that looks pretty good. And it just automatically wrapped it around her arm, which is great. Now, if you're having trouble getting it in the right spot, we do have the Gizmo tool as well to help you. You know, I really like to click on those arrows to bring it up or down if I need to, or maybe if I hit the number 2, I'm looking at it straight on. I'm gonna right click a little just so I can get this red arrow if I ever need to bring it in or out. The green one's gonna rotate it around in a circle. And same with the blue one as well. So those are like a lot of directional tools for you as well. Okay, I'm gonna hit the number 2 again. Here we have a hood. Today I'm not gonna use the hood. I'm just gonna delete it to make our demo a little faster. And then the last part is we have some kind of rib trim. So I guess I'll put that. Ooh, this one's going the wrong way. So I'm gonna actually change it on my 2D window to rotate it. Hold down shift so it goes to a perfect 90 degree angle. And then what I'm gonna do in my 3D window, I'm gonna reset the placement of this guy because when I initially drew it, I drew it straight up and down. Let's see here. So I'm gonna go ahead and right click and say reset 2D arrangement. Cool. And then now I can place it where I need to. Maybe actually it's gonna wrap around her, so I'll do this little side dot here. Okay, so make sure your pieces are arranged, and then the next step will be to sew them together.